Hi, and welcome to the Undergraduate Research Symposium Abstract Writing Workshop. This event and workshop are hosted by the Undergraduate Research Program at the University of Washington. My name is Delaney, and I'm the Graduate Staff Assistant, and I'll be guiding you through this abstract writing workshop today. In this workshop, we will cover the following information: the symposium application, writing an abstract, and submitting your abstract for Symposium. On the Symposium application site, you will need to provide the following information, seen on the left-hand side of the screen: an information release, personal information such as your name and major, any co-presenters, research mentors, project information, and your session presentation type. The page we are looking at right now is the page for project information. This is the page where we will ask you for both a title for your presentation and your abstract, which is a brief summary of your work. There are different types of presentations you can give at Symposium. You can review the different types of presentations on our website. All of the presentation types require an abstract. However, those planning to give a visual arts and design presentation can submit either an abstract or an artist statement. We won't be covering how to write an artist statement in this video, but we are more than happy to meet with students who need more guidance on that. The last section of the application includes an opportunity to apply for the Population Health Recognition Award. If you have a project that is relevant to population health, consider applying. All disciplines are welcome to apply. You may be wondering, what is an abstract? How do you write one? Next, we will be helping you answer those questions. So, what is an abstract? An abstract is a concise summary of a larger document or presentation. It highlights major points covered in the work, and it makes it possible for readers to quickly determine the content of the work. Now let's talk about qualities of a great abstract. There are a few qualities of a great abstract. A great abstract is a brief, well-developed summary of your project that is coherent, concise, and able to stand alone. It's understandable to a non-expert audience. Make sure to avoid jargon and define the terms that may not be familiar to the audience. Great abstracts also include a title that concisely describes the abstract. Exceptional titles are ones that are short, avoid jargon, and catch the audience's eye. However, your abstract should not include section headers, references, or footnotes. Some more qualities that we can talk about are that a great abstract is one that adheres to the standards of the conference or journal. For the Undergraduate Research Symposium, the abstract should not exceed 300 words in length. We also ask that you use the active voice in your writing. For example, you should use language like, "We conducted a literature review," instead of, "A literature review was conducted." When writing your background and methods, be careful to not use statements like, "will be." For example, avoid statements like, "In the future, I will be extracting DNA." Instead, talk about your work in terms of what will be completed by the day of the symposium by using past or present tense. For example, you could say, "In this study, we use X methods to explore XYZ." Or, "In this project, I conduct a literature review of," which are both present tense. And make sure that your abstract is approved by your mentor. That's a really important part of this. As I mentioned, mentor approval is key. It's important to consider the ways that intellectual property may influence your writing and presentation. In some cases, your mentor may have specific ways they want you to disclose information about the project in your abstract and in your presentation. In order to protect intellectual property, there may be aspects of your project that your mentor prefers to keep confidential until the project is completed. Therefore, it's very important that you have your mentor approve your abstract before you submit it. Other ways that you can protect intellectual property. You can use your own words, paraphrase rather than quote, cite by name since you cannot use in-text citations in your abstract, for example, X's hypothesis or so-and-so's hypothesis. Check your writing with a free online plagiarism checker. However, you do not want to copy and paste text from someone else's published or unpublished work, quote without proper indications or citations, and forget to give credit to people or ideas that preceded yours. Now that we know what an abstract is, we should talk about the components of an abstract. First, you want to set the context and the purpose of the research. This is a great place to demonstrate why your research is important and necessary. Second, you want to state the research question or hypothesis, then briefly describe the methods. Next, describe the results or the anticipated results. Finally, explain the key implications or suggestions for future work. Each of these components should be about 1 to 3 sentences long, and remember that the word count for the UW Symposium is 300 words. Here, we outline steps you can take to streamline writing your abstract. First, review your research notes and other relevant documents. Second, draft a summary of your work. In many cases, free writing can be helpful. Don't worry about grammar or spelling in the first draft. Third, go back and revise your rough draft. Writing is strengthened by frequent revising. You may want to do this several times. Fourth, get feedback from your colleagues and friends, and then revise again. After lots of feedback and revisions, create a final draft and send it to your mentor for final. Now let's talk a little bit more about strategies for revising your abstracts. It may be helpful to think to yourself and ask yourself the following questions. Did I minimize jargon, define key terms, and spell out any acronyms? This will help to ensure that your abstract is easily understood by members of the public. Did I eliminate unnecessary words or sentences and avoid repeated information? Abstracts should be as short and concise as possible. Did I provide logical connections or transitions between the information included? Abstracts are easiest to read when they flow logically from one idea to the next. Another question to ask yourself is, did I describe the project in terms of what will have been completed by Symposium? In other words, did I avoid will be statements in my background and methods? It's totally fine if your project isn't yet completed. We just want to make sure that your abstract reflects the work you will have done by the event and not what you plan to do. Lastly, you should ask yourself, did I use active voice? Again, you want to avoid passive voice in your abstract. Now we'll take a moment to read the abstract on the screen. You can go ahead and pause while you do this. Look for and identify the following abstract components and any strengths or areas for improvement. When you're ready to move on, unpause your video. Here we see the title of the project. It is concise and clearly informs the audience of what they will be hearing about. Here we have the background information that introduces the research question, its importance, and why it's being explored. Next, we see the main purpose of the project is clearly stated along with a specific goal they aim to achieve. That is, to learn more about the social benefits from the perspective of community gardeners in Seattle. However, notice that the purpose is stated twice, once in the first highlighted sentence and then again in the next highlighted section. Next is the methods section, which is concise and smoothly describes the flow of how research was conducted. Notice how the author uses passive voice several times, such as when saying, "Interviews were conducted." We would recommend using the active voice instead and saying, "We conducted interviews." Also note that responses in the last highlighted sentence is spelled incorrectly. Again, in the results, we see the author uses passive voice when they should be using active voice. Note that this author did not finish the results by the time they submitted the abstract, but instead they stated the potential impact of their forthcoming results. This is a great way to discuss your project, even if your results are not available yet. To conclude, the author highlights the implications of their work and how it could be applied for the future. So now let's review the strengths and areas of improvement for this abstract. For strengths, it sets the context for the research question well, so the reader clearly understands why this research is relevant. The author describes work that has been completed instead of talking about the work that will be done in the future. The methods were concise and free of any jargon and technical language. The implications of the research were clearly stated at the end of the paragraph. For areas of improvement, the purpose is stated twice. This author frequently uses passive voice throughout the abstract. Finally, a typo was left in the final version that should have been caught in the revision process. Now we'll do a second example. Take a moment, pause, and read the abstract. Same as for the last example, see if you can identify the following abstract components, any strengths, and any areas of improvement. When you're ready to move on, unpause your video. Here we've identified the title as the first component of the abstract. The title should be in title case, where every significant word in the title is capitalized. This title concisely describes the research topic, but notice the typo in the word instability. Next, the background information is found at the beginning of the paragraph, including information on genetic instability and how it may relate to tumors, chemotherapy, and radiation therapy. The purpose is stated in the sentence, "The goal of our project is to find ways of eliminating unstable cells," so the reader knows that the author is trying to find methods that would remove unstable cells. In the second highlighted sentence, the author uses the passive voice. This sentence needs to be revised and changed to the active voice. Next, the research question or hypothesis includes the approach that the project will use, in this case, a chemical inhibitor of DNA repair or the drug wirtmannin. Note again the passive voice used in this portion of the abstract. The methods section is a strength of this abstract. Their methods are clear and the goals are clearly stated. However, a few revisions need to be made. The term dicentric chromosomes needs to be defined so that the general audience can understand what they are. Additionally, they use the future tense for statements such as "the drug we will test" and "we will culture stable and unstable clones." These statements need to be revised to past or present tense. This abstract includes anticipated results by saying, "Therefore, we should see the frequency of dicentrics decrease over time because the cells with unrepaired breaks will not grow." This is a great way to write your results section if your project is not yet complete. The last sentence of the abstract includes implications of the work as being able to be applied clinically. This statement should be expanded to include more detail about what clinical applications there may be. Some strengths of this abstract are a strong introductory sentence. and setup to the thesis or purpose statement, clear methodology and goals, and a conclusion with a hypothesis or anticipated results. Some areas for improvement are defining dicentric chromosomes. It's an important term that helps with determining the results of this research project. All in the future tense and passive voice. These need to be written in the past tense or present to reflect reading on symposium day and using the active voice. There was a title typo, and the implications at the end could be more clearly stated. Next, we'll cover submitting your abstract, the review process for Symposium, and a few details about the Undergraduate Research Symposium. The following steps should be used when submitting your abstract within the Symposium application. Step 1 is to write your abstract in Word or another word processing program. Step 2 is copy and paste your abstract into a text editor, Notepad or Mac text editor. Step 3, copy the unformatted text into the abstract field. Review and adjust all special formatting, for example, species names, Greek letters, or math symbols, and other characters using the icons circled on the screen. Our goal is to help ensure everyone can present the best version of their research, so we provide feedback to students to improve abstracts before they're finalized. These are possible outcomes of your abstract submission. Your abstract may be accepted as is and no changes will be needed. You may receive minor revisions. Here, URP will make small suggestions to your abstract and will submit the changes for you. For example, we may need to change the title case. You may receive minor revisions where URP will make small suggestions, but you will need to go into the system and submit the changes, for example, acronyms that were not defined. You may receive a full revision. In this case, more extensive revisions will be needed and we'll ask you to schedule a feedback appointment with us so that we can talk through them together. In rare circumstances, URP may reject an abstract if the student has described something that is not actually research, for example, a story about a study abroad experience, or does not have mentor approval of their abstract. We wanted to take a minute to highlight a few common reasons why students require revisions on their abstract. Abstracts often require revisions when the title is not in title case, when acronyms are not defined, when passive voice is used, when the abstract includes in-text references, when will-be statements are used in the background and methods, when there are formatting issues from copying and pasting text from a word processing program instead of a text editor, when key terms are not defined for a general audience, or when your specific role in the research project is not clear. As you move through the process of preparing and submitting your abstract, be sure to utilize the URP website for more information and resources. Our website has examples of abstracts from past student presentations. It may be helpful for you to read a few to get ideas for abstract flow and sentence structure. Additional information about symposium resources will be provided via our symposium application dashboard. Finally, you can connect with the Odegaard Writing and Research Center for additional support.